Today we are going to show you how to make a simple relay circuit. The things you need are two LEDs, a 10 k ohm resistor, a 9 volt battery, a 9 volt battery clip, a switch. You need to solder two wires from the two terminals. We won't be needing the third terminal. We need a 6 volt power supply. If you don't have a 6 volt power supply, you can use another 9 volt battery along with a 7806 regulator, which will convert the 9 volts into 6 volts. Next, we need the 6 volt relay, which is the most important component in our project. A relay is an electrical device that allows current flowing in one circuit to control the current flowing in another circuit. Relays are often used in situations where a small current flow can turn on a machine that requires a large current flow or high voltage. This makes a system much safer. If only a little voltage is needed to turn the relay on, a switch or button that a human must come in contact with to activate the larger system would present no shock hazard. It would only have to hold on enough current to turn on a relay. Relays can also be used to complete one circuit when the electromagnet is turned off and another circuit when the electromagnet is energized. Thus, as you've seen, there are two terminals here. These two are the coil terminals that activate the electromagnet. This is the movable contact and this one, this is the normally open and this is normally closed. Here I have an instrument. You will not be needing this in the project. I'm just demonstrating. Its bulb lights up when the two terminals connect. So normally open and movable contact, when they come in contact with each other, bulb glows. Whereas when the two normally closed and movable contact, it does not glow. When the terminals will be powered, these two will get connected, whereas this will get turned off. And next we need the breadboard, where this will be the positive terminal and this the negative terminal. And now we have the circuit diagram. We start by inserting the relay on the breadboard. This coil terminal is 1, the other coil terminal is 2, normally closed terminal is 3, normally open terminal is 4, and the movable contact is 5. We insert it on the breadboard. Be sure where the terminals get inserted on the breadboard. Next, we need to insert the two LEDs on the breadboard. The longer part of each LED is the anode and the shorter part is the cathode. So we connect the anode of the first LED to normally open and the cathode to the negative rail of the breadboard. We connect the anode of the second LED to normally closed and the cathode to the negative rail of the breadboard. Next up, we take the 10 k ohm resistor. We connect it from the movable contact of the relay to the positive rail of the breadboard. Now we connect the 6 volt power supply. I have already connected the positive of the 6 volt power supply to my positive, and the other part I'll connect it to one of the terminals, and the negative of the 6 volt power supply to the other terminal. Coil terminal 1, this is the positive of the 6 volt, and this coil terminal, this is 1 and this is 2, and this is the positive and this is the negative. Now we connect the 9 volt battery to the 9 volt battery clip, and we connect the negative terminal of the battery clip to the negative rail of the breadboard, and the positive terminal to the positive rail. As you can see, one of the LEDs is lit up. As soon as you switch on, the second one goes on. And as soon as we switch it off, the first one is back. So here, when we switch it on, the electromagnet gets started and the second circuit glows. We can assume the bulb one to be circuit 1 and the second LED to be circuit 2. So when we switch it on, circuit 2 is on, and we switch it off, circuit 1. So it's kind of this relay is using the 6 volt power supply to switch between the both circuits, whereas both the circuits are using the 9 volt power supply to run. So here we have successfully made the simple relay circuit. Video by Achal Jain and Yashwardhan Jain. Please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.